Turkey's TFX Stealthy New Fighter. The TFX Next Generation Fighter, which is being built by Turkish Aerospace Industries, starting to take shape. The size of the jet makes an immediate impression. The first prototype of the TFX, the program is known as Milli Muharip Ucak, MMU, or National Combat Aircraft, in Turkey, is now on the assembly line in Ankara, with the bulk of the fuselage and wings having been brought together. The twin engines are clearly still missing. During an official visit to the assembly line by members of the Turkish Defense Ministry, Defense Industrial Agency, and the Turkish Air Force. While slightly smaller than the US Air Force's F-22 Raptor, the TFX is somewhat larger than the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter, with an overall length of 60 feet and a wingspan of 39 feet. Reports suggest that the prototype is scheduled to be rolled out on 2023. This seems ambitious, at least if the aircraft is to be rolled out in its completed form. The maiden flight is reportedly scheduled to take place in 2025 or 2026, and the first production machines should start to be delivered to the Turkish Air Force in the early 2030s. When a full-size mock-up of the fighter was unveiled at the Paris Air Show in 2019. The TFX program of developing a homegrown fifth-generation combat aircraft. From the outset, it was to include a degree of stealth characteristics, advanced avionics, and a high level of performance. In terms of stealth, it's thought that the TFX will not be in the same league as the F-22 or F-35, for example. However, Turkey was kicked out of the Joint Strike Fighter program in 2019, after it refused to abandon plans to purchase Russian S-400 air defense systems, which the United States judged posed a significant security risk. With the F-35 suddenly taken out of the equation, Turkey has looked for ways to get more out of the F-16 fleet. This has included a domestic midlife update program, as well as plans to buy 40 new F-16 Block 70-72 jets plus kits to upgrade another 80 of its existing F-16C/Ds to the same standard. Another option to address fighter mass, albeit in the longer term, would be to introduce the Bayraktar Kizilelma drone, which is being billed as the country's first unmanned fighter aircraft, but which is yet to fly. More F-16s would provide a stopgap until the TFX can be fielded in numbers. The strained relationship between Ankara and Washington means that it's by no means certain that such a deal will go ahead. Once again, it looks like the future of the Turkish Air Force is very much dependent on the TFX becoming a success. Developing a new fighter, stealthy or otherwise, is a major undertaking, and a very costly one, especially when a country decides to go it alone. It may well be that Turkey requires an injection of funds from foreign sales in order to keep the TFX program on schedule, although there are their competitors out there, not least the F-35, but other options, including from China and Russia. As it stands, Turkey's need for new fighter jets is only going to grow. It remains to be seen whether the TFX program is able to meet that requirement and the timeline that has been set out. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.